afternoon. My name is Rapio Tanzov and I'll be explaining what exactly is knowledge. A few days ago, a friend and I had an argument. She asked me something and I said, because I know. But to be honest, I really didn't know. And she asked me, how do I know? And then I said, I just do. But in all honesty, it left me wondering, what exactly does it mean to know something? So like me, you might think you know a lot, but do you really know what it means to know something? Philosophers prefer the term epistemology. Epistemology comes from two Greek words, epistem, which means knowledge, and logia, which means study. So in general, the word epistemology means the study of knowledge. Philosophers have very lucid ideas when it comes to words such as justification, belief, proposition, and know. To hold your own philosophical devices in an argument, you'll need to know the difference between two words that sound exactly the same but are actually really different, an assertion and a proposition. An assertion is a linguistic act, either written or spoken, that has a truth value. And no matter how it sounds, a truth value does not mean a measurement of how true something is, but rather whether something is true, false, or indeterminate. All sentences that assert something from the past or the present are either true or false, but all sentences that assert something of the future are indeterminate. For example, I'm going to assert that it is going to rain at the end of my speech, but this assertion is indeterminate because I do not know, because I did not finish my speech yet. Proposition. A proposition is the underlying meaning of what you are saying. It is also your propositional attitude, whether you believe in what you are saying or whether you just think you know what you are saying. A proposition is true if its assertion is a claim that corresponds to reality. So let's start with the traditional definition for knowledge. The traditional definition for knowledge is a justified true belief. You can split these words up in definition to three different words: justified, true, and belief. Starting with justified, justified would be anything that is a testimony. So whenever you read something from a book or when your teacher explains something to you in class, that's all testimony, or someone who is experienced in the topic tells you something. And your belief is if you believe in what you are saying or if you just not believe in what you're saying. So that will give you a propositional attitude of disbelief or propositional attitude of belief. And something is only true whether it is stated, whether it is a fact or when it's proven. Edmund Gettier was one of the first philosophers to study knowledge. He made something that was called Gettier cases, which proved that you could have justified true belief without actually having knowledge. So let me tell you a story. James and Marcus applied for the same job, and the president of the company told James that Marcus was going to get the job. So in the other room, James made the assertion that whoever wore the best tie would get the job. But turns out that the president's testimony was wrong, and it's James who gets the job and not Marcus. So here in this story you have a case of justified true belief. Just because James thought he didn't have a better looking tie than Marcus, it made him believe that Marcus was going to get the job. But in all honesty, the president of the company was wrong, so James got the job because his tie was better looking. So if you can have a justified true belief and it's not actually knowledge, but the definition of knowledge is a justified true belief, what exactly is knowledge? Thank you.